The Philippines confirms two more cases of the Delta COVID-19 variant. The health department identified them as Filipino migrant workers who arrived from Saudi Arabia on May 29. Both have recovered and have been discharged from the quarantine facility after spending 10 days in isolation. In total, the Philippines has now had 19 cases of the Delta variant, which is believed to be the most transmissible out of all the new COVID strains that have emerged. Meanwhile, the DOH also detected an additional 132 Alpha variant cases, 119 Beta variant cases, and 3 Theta variant cases. Only 20 of these remain active.
Philippine authorities also monitoring another COVID-19 mutation that has now made its way to several countries. The World Health Organization back in June tagged the so-called Lambda variant as a variant of concern. According to the global body, the variant was initially detected in Peru in August last year. It has since spread to around 29 countries, mostly in Latin America. The Philippine Health Department says so far the variant has not been detected in the country. It adds there is no evidence yet that the Lambda variant is more deadly compared to other variants.
A former health advisor to the Philippine government warns about the dangerous consequences of branding the COVID-19 situation in the country as low risk. Dr. Tony Liachon says while he is not surprised that government is stonewalling critical health information, it should not mislead the public into thinking that the COVID-19 situation in the country has greatly improved.
Local data have not shown that we are improving. Number two, international surveys have confirmed this, and I don't think that it is correct that we brand ourselves as low risk when the figures are actually not telling this. This particular type of, you know, trying to condition the public, if I may say, is quite reminiscent of Donald Trump's strategy during the time of the election, that they would like to project this kind of situation.
The DOH logged nearly 5,400 new cases of the original COVID-19 strain Monday. This brings the number of active infections to 51,594. 43 more people died, while 6,477 have recovered from the disease.